All right, welcome to this week's Secret Stash release. This one is a fun one, and it's because it's from my friend Christopher Farron of Aviary Coffee. So I'm wearing the nice t-shirt here. But Aviary coming out of Cleveland, Ohio, micro roastery focusing on roasting and sourcing beautiful, beautiful coffees like this one. So let's talk a little bit about this coffee. We'll brew it and we'll give it a taste, and hopefully you will enjoy that. This is a wash pink bourbon from producer Abelardo Medina. It is a super expressive pink bourbon coffee that I would say if you taste this coffee, you'll be like, wow, I did not realize pink bourbon could taste like that, especially in the sense of directions of how the dynamics are presented and flavors. Main thing that I am experiencing when brewing this coffee is this really amazing tropical flavor note. I think something like passion fruit will come out, and there's a lot of really nice jasmine and some bit of florality at the end that makes this really interesting if you've never tasted a pink bourbon that skews yellow fruit tasting or tropical fruit tasting. So let's go ahead and brew this. This is a coffee that I have quite enjoyed. When you think about a lot of wash coffees, especially things like pink bourbons, of course they're going to be loud, but if they're really well roasted and of this caliber, there is something just special about them. There's a level of expressiveness and dynamics that I quite enjoy. So let's get that going. Ooh, that smells nice. I also think this is a coffee that really benefits from resting. When you guys get it in, it probably will be around 2 weeks off roast. I have found that this roasting style and these coffees, especially from Aviary, perform very well in the 4 to 6, even 8 to 10 week range. So I would really recommend you save some of the pods for that experience. As this coffee brews, to me it smells very, very sweet. I want to say there is some sort of tea, maybe even a floral component of it, that is definitely adds this interesting layering in the cup. We'll definitely experience that as we begin tasting it. But recipe I'm opting for is 1 to 17, hotter temperatures. For these coffees, if you guys have been on Secret Stash long enough, you guys will see that I do like to push these coffees fairly hard. There are a lot of different approaches of how to brew these coffees. For this coffee, I think this is an incredibly strong baseline recipe for you guys to start with. Feel free to adjust. But also, this is a coffee that's going to really open up as it begins resting. What's going to be quite interesting as we begin tasting this coffee is this kind of depth of acidity, complexity, out of a pink bourbon. You know, these are things where you would expect to be qualities of a very complex geisha, but we're getting them in pink bourbon, plus the kind of kick and loudness of a really nice wash pink bourbon. And it's all gonna kind of skew in kind of this yellow fruit direction. So I'm very excited for you guys to taste. This is a roasting style and coffee that can benefit from, I would say, higher extractions, longer brew time. Although what's nice about coffees that are this expressive is even if you do a recipe that doesn't push the coffee that hard, it is still going to taste pretty good. So there we go. Wrapping up at about 4 minutes. All right, got the coffee in. Very jasmine-y. This is something that I haven't experienced in a lot of pink bourbons, is this kind of interesting tea component. When it's hot, let me tell you about what I experience. It smells great. You can actually smell, you can totally tell it's a pink bourbon, but then it skews in a direction with two things here, the brew that I'm smelling. One is this yellow fruit component, tropicalness, and then two is this tea component, which is like interesting. Usually you would expect these pink bourbons to be like very loud fruit, loud acidity, but I'm getting kind of both here, which is interesting. Very sweet. Wow, very upfront tea. Jasmine-y. Am I drinking Panama Geisha? But there's a really nice linger of sweetness. Acidity is kind of coating the back of my palate as it's hot. Let's let this cool down. Coffees like this that are very complex, that have these layerings, especially in the acidity, really benefit from cooling them down. I mentioned this in every Secret Stash video. I said, guys, let the coffee cool down as you taste. This is for sure one of these coffees that as it gets closer to room temperature, you're going to really experience a lot of those really subtle complexities, or really those subtle complexities are not gonna be so subtle anymore. And they're gonna really start opening up. It's gonna taste amazing. Here we go. Now that it is cooler, I always like to pour a little bit in the cup, swirl it around, get it a little bit cooler. Let's taste it now. Tropical acidity. I think it's kind of like a passion fruit, maybe like a nectarine, that type of acidity really starts to peak up in the brew, but it's enveloped in this really nice, clean sweetness. And I think once this cup really, really starts to cool, we're going to get more and more of that acidity is going to start to punch through. What is interesting is there is this finish that is very tea-like, very jasmine-y, and very, very clean. This cup that I brewed here went up to 4 minutes of brew time, which for a lot of our other coffees might be a little on the finer end, but it still tastes like there is more things to get out of this coffee, which is quite amazing. Super clean, jasmine-y, sweet. My entire palate is getting enveloped in this really nice, really, really nice subtle sweetness, but there's a really interesting depth of complexity here. So in this coffee, I think what's really interesting as this is cooled down, I think this is a great experience if you have never tasted coffees that are very complex, is there are is how is the acidity tied to the rest of the cup? For me, the two main things that I'm experiencing in this coffee are this yellow fruit acidity that is then very well tied together to this jasmine tea component that then finishes really clean and sweet. And everything is enveloped in this really light, subtle sweetness. We're tasting kind of two things here, in my opinion. The first thing you experience, you're getting this layer of sweetness, then it gets into the acidity, then it gets into jasmine. And the second thing is, how is that acidity that we're experiencing, in this case, maybe like a passion fruit or nectarine or tropical flavor note, tied together to the back end, to the finish, which is this jasmine component. That's really the interesting thing for me when this coffee cools down, is there's kind of two really big layerings and harmony tying together of flavor notes that are happening. So we're getting the depth and we're getting the harmony. Mm. Now that it's really cooled down, I'm getting this really nice structure of acidity. So the acidity has become very well defined. It's high in terms of the acidity, but it's quite well tied together to everything else. And there's so much layering in this. So this is a really, really enjoyable cup. It's dynamic, it's expressive, it's clean. If you've been on Secret Stash long enough, you definitely know I love these very loud coffees. And this coffee definitely becomes very loud when it cools down. But that's the kind of fun thing with these releases we do on Secret Stash, is we're able to chase different flavor profiles. We're able to showcase these types of coffees. And I wanted to thank everybody who was on Secret Stash. We're getting into our holiday season, so we have a bunch of holiday coffees. We're releasing more videos on the YouTube channel. And for anybody who is interested in joining Secret Stash, now is the time to join. We have a few more slots available, and we have coffees from some of our previous releases that might be still around. This is a coffee that I would really like people to enjoy. We put in a lot of effort to get these coffees and, you know, tell the story and do all of that so you guys can experience amazing coffees. So I really want to thank everybody for spending the time to watch this video. That's this week's Secret Stash release. Be on the lookout for a lot more exciting things and videos on the YouTube channel. We're starting to make more videos. So thank you so much. I'll see you guys in the next one.